Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back. This is Gixu again, and welcome back to the Diamond Society, and welcome back after Christmas. I hope you had a very pleasant holiday with those you love, whether it being family or friends, and that you got some good presents that you like, and in general that you are well. You do deserve it. You do indeed deserve it. We are over here in the forest, in this lovely little cove that we built a couple of episodes ago. We did a little bit, not last episode, but the episode before that. And I did this. And this is looking wonderful, you must admit. Come on, look at the lovely diary, the grand. Yes, yes, yes. No. We definitely want to change it up. So, what I want to do over here, as I talked about before, is I want to build a bandit camp. And one of the ways to do that, one could say, is to build tents. That's at least what my plan is. I want to build some tents in here for our bandits to be in. So if we start off by actually replacing all of this ugly granite with some lovely blue clay, three there, right, and two down here, we can start establish the big tent. This is going to be the, you can say, the leader's tent. It's going to be the biggest one of them all. One to rule them all, you know. That's how we need to make so one rule them all. That's how it is. But yeah, if we then just quickly jump over here. How is it again? We make a two, and then we make a three, then we make a something like this, I think. Yep, seems about right. I can't remember how we do these things. Yeah, that seems right, and then we do something like that, and that. Yeah, okay, good. So that's the one side, looking splendid. And the reason we got this of diorite in the way, and it is in the way. We don't want diorite there. Is we want to make this kind of outline for the tent in the white clay. So that's kind of what we are going to do over in this area. So let me try and see if I can get the rest of this little back side of the tent done, and I'll be back in a little bit. Alright, it is built up, and we are ready to move on to the next part. I like this, it's a big one, but again, it's the leader's tent, and the leader's tent always need to be big, we know that. So if we take this, and this is going to be the tent color itself, so that's 4, 5, 6, 7. Yeah, that should do the trick. If we take 7 out like that, and do the same over here, and then again over here, and you guessed it, that's correct, over here, kind of do the same as on the, yes, I was about to say yellow, but it's white on the outside. So we take this, and that's the same as we did on the outside, but taking these all the way down, oh, like that, and like that. You can probably see we are going to have a little bit of a problem here. So, we need to move you, because you are in the way, and we are doing, and we will end up having to do a little bit of terraform. Not much, but again, you know, just a tiny bit to ensure that everything is just where it should be. So this one will go 5, and then we will go 3, and then we'll go 1. And we will quickly fill these in on the other side, just like that. Love it, love it. This is going to look good. This is going to look good. And then on the other side here, we of course going to just go 3. We're going to go 2. Then we're going to go 3 again. And now you can see we're having the trouble with this area, so we need to do a little bit of terraforming around here. Not much, but you know, just to make this look a little bit more correct, if we can say it like that. But I know you can place a tent on a uphill slope. I know, but to be fair, have you ever slept in a tent on an uphill slope? It's not pleasant. Sorry to say, it isn't. So we will do just as we did on the front side. Put the white as a border. Oh, this is going completely wrong. Oh no! We are destroying everything. There we go. Okay, much better, much better. And you go there, and you go there. Okay, okay. And where did I? You go. All right. So on this side over here, we are having a little bit more trouble. Actually, we need to do a little bit of chopping on the chopped tree, so to say. So let me get that chopped away, just as we need it, and I'll be right back with you. All right, we got the little tree chopping done. You can see I kind of. The thinking was that I wanted to make this tree, when it's chopped down, look like they have been just chopping down trees everywhere, and then they have put up the tents where they just could fit them in. So it's kind of like, okay, we need to chop down some small branches here, and then the our tent can be there. So that's good, that's good. What I want to do in here is I want to create some kind of holders for our tent, and I'm stuck. Come on. Nope, wrong. Definitely wrong. We want these fence posts. It's kind of rope, but not kind of rope anyway. So they're kind of good for the rope. yeah. So if we just quickly put these. No. That's not gonna cut it. Maybe we can do something like that. Say okay. We can. Yeah, I think that could work. We do the same over here. Other side is complete now. Take me to the other side. No. I'm not sure what that was. We also need to ensure that this tent will be stable in case some hurricanes are. In general, just some real autumn weather. I can tell you, in Denmark, autumn weather means way too much wind and way too much rain, basically. So you can say that's more or less like Ireland all the year round. I'm not entirely sure on that, but I guess. So yeah, if we just quickly do something like this and fill it in and eat a bunch of. It's mutton. Mutton is the word. I lost the word. Bird is the. No, we don't want to get started on that, and we still need, remember, a little bit of light in here. We don't want mobs to spawn in here and blow up our lovely new built tent. So if we just do something like that, and you can say this rope is kind of anchored into the. That's kind of angry, but it's angled into the wall. This tent must not fall, so we have anchored it to the wall. Right. So yeah, this is looking pretty good, I would say. We are coming a good way. This is the back end, of course. You could. I will have a little. Maybe we could add some kind of a little pen out here with some storage chest or something. I'll have a look on that. But let's get onto the front side here. And this is the inside. Okay, I want to do the same over here. I kind of. Run out. I don't like to run out. So if we do something like that. Okay, I can see this one needs to get at least something like that. If we do. How do we do this most efficient way? Is that better? I think that's good. That makes sense. And then we of course need a little bit of stabilizing to the tent. We don't want this tent to fall apart. That would be a bit of a shame. So if we take this one and just anchor, like we really. Okay, that's kind of the only problem there is with building on a wall or in a hole, basically. You can't. You are stuck sometimes when you have to place things. You see, I could place the tree the other way around. It wouldn't matter much, but I kind of like that. I like that this fence post. It's nicely snuggled in there, right in the middle of the wood block. I like that. Anyway, we got this kind of thing to hold it up, and now we still need, as always, to put in some of these ropes to ensure that this tree won't tree. No, this tent won't fall whenever there's a wind in the forest, and it's way. It's not nice to be out, so we want to be sure we can be inside. Basically, I can't remember the right words. Oh, this is going to snuggle just nice. Oh, look at that. That's nice. And we move you out of the question. And where are you? You are there. So if we put you the right there. Beep. I like that. Maybe we are going to move this one over by one block. I might do that. I might. And how is this looking? This is good. This is good. I like that. And we going to chop you down. And we're going to fill you in. All right, much better. I like that. It's kind of like you can just quickly stumble up here. So what we are going to do? This is kind of the tent. I'm not sure I want to do anything in here. Maybe some coarse dirt actually. Coarse dirt is definitely looking good in here. But what I also think would look good is if we try and give some life to this area, and this is one wide, which I do not actually. damn it! What do we do? Okay, we do something like this, I guess. Okay. So if I put this one, no. This is going to be quite good. So if we put this one, okay, this one there, right? This one there. Yeah, look at that. And that's because the bandit camp, which is located right here, as you can see, is where we will, this is where the base of the operation is. We might actually extend this area out and make it a 3x3 area. Hey, there's a lot of things to do. one thing at a time. We want to... Where is you? There you are. Stupid thingy getting away from me. We need to ensure that no bad things could get in here. That would be a shame if they did. So there we go. Safe and sound. We need the guy needs somewhere to sleep. We know that we can't. If we put a bed right there, I can't sleep in it. Alright. I forgot the note blocks. However, we do have the armor stand. Because this is of course his private quarters. No, I don't want to equip it. So we want to make it look like he's living here, like he's preparing for battle and ensuring that his bandit camp here can get all the loot they want from these trains. I like that. Oh, they're glowing. What else can we do for decoration purposes? We can eat some steak and we can apparently go crazy with the fence post. But we don't want the fence post. Get out. Get lost. Get kicked. What else? You know what? Let's put one of these guys. Let's do something like that. And then do... I think we can do something like this. And then, just for good measure, we do something like that. And I have run out. Wonderful. Do we have more? Okay, we can make this. We can do this. I believe in myself. Do you believe in me? I hope you do, because I will show you that I can. And... Alright, I didn't understand what happened there, but that's okay. And if I did do... No. Something like that. Yes. And remove you and do something like that. And we got a little table. Wonderful. We do, however, not have anything to put on the table. I think we could do. We are just borrowing his bed for the night because baddies are out there and baddies are bad. And I don't like to play with the baddies if I can avoid it, if I must be honest. Okay, we want one there, and... Did I miscount that? I miscounted on everything, actually. Interesting. That's kind of interesting. I work with numbers, but apparently I can't count. Alrighty. Okay, what else? I got a bookshelf, because I believe a great leader, good or bad, still needs to read. And have, have something to read about, maybe inspired by Caesar or Hannibal the Great or Genghis Khan, something like that. He might be inspired by someone. And we also need some goods to be stored, And I know that isn't looking pretty, so where are they? They are there. No, 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 no. Okay. Come on. No, god freaking damn it. Okay, we do it like this then. Flip. Flip. Oh my goodness, come on. And flip. Alright, alright, much better. And then we can put that one there and we can put bookshelf back right there. I like it, I like it. This is getting cozy. And what else? What else? You know, we got that one. If we do something like that and do something like that, could we do something like that? We could. And could we also? We could. We only need one though. And yeah. Alright, that means we actually got enough for over there. That's a good thing. And that doesn't work on that, apparently. Why doesn't mid-click work? Alright, so we can fill that in. But before we do that, I want to do a little trick here. So if we... oh, that's going to be a big, good question. Where is the armor stand? Didn't I bring an armor stand with me? I did not. Why didn't I bring an armor stand with me when I need an armor stand to perform what I want to perform? That is the question for today. If you can answer that down in the comment section and you understand that, I would greatly appreciate it because this is actually kind of annoying. Alright, we got the armor stand acquired. So if I do... Is it right there? I believe it is. So if I do that, put a block on top of it, and then do something like... this. No. I am supposed to push you, ain't I? Alright then, that means we do something like that, and then we do something like that, and then we do. And that of course doesn't work, because it needs to power that one. Oh, of course, it's the... that's gonna destroy things, actually. You know what, we're going to do it anyway. Wait. We're definitely going to destroy things anyway. Come here. Okay. We put this one there. Remove you. And I'm going to remove you again, because I fear... Yep. There we go. Alright. And if I then push... If I do something like that, does that work? That does work. Oh, we need a slap. Give me a slap. Where is the slap? There's a slap. Okay. Come on. No. Freaking hell. Back with you. Okay, good. So far, so good. And then we put down the armor stand. We need to put that one there first. Put the armor stand down. Remove that one. The armor stand will stand there. And now the pushy-pushy... Piston pushing thingy fang fang land something, and I want you to be located like that. That seems about right. Okay, so if I put that one down again, put that one down there, and put the piston and push. Huh? Oh, that doesn't work. But we can do it like that because this is a sticky one. I forgot that. Right? Huh? Look at that! Problem solved. Oh. Can that be solved by just placing that one? No, it cannot. How on earth was that done? That's kind of interesting, I must admit. You know what? I know how we are going to solve this problem. Alright. I know how he does it now. I know how he does this. So, let's get in there. Let's see. Okay. Open. Close. And remove you. Remove you. Alright, we got everything. So, over here we need... There you were. Alright, we need one of these guys. This is how it's done. Now, If we put this one down there, bloop, put that one down there, put, and continue the process from before. Let's quickly move you like that. Yeah, I like that. I like that. Okay, let's continue the process from before. Now, will you look at this? I like that. He got a helmet on the table. Oh, is that wonderful? That's wonderful. I do, however, think that if we could, this, he's a. No, of course I cannot do that. On the piston pushing thingy, majingy again. Oh, and destroying the whole tent again. Apparently, that seems to be how it does thing today. So, put you there. Put you. Oh, why can't I? Can I do something like that? No. Right. I think we need to do it from the other way around. So if we put, where did our piston go? It goes down there. All right. So if I put that one there, and then power that one. No. Why did I do that? That was stupid. okay, I can do that. Apparently, okay. Let's do something like this then. Now, can I do something like this? I can. All right. And then you're going to move it again, of course, because you're a sticky one. So I'll move you. All right. So if I then do the same trick as before, give me my redstone block, give me that, give me that, give me that. Yep. Thought so. But that's okay, actually. How do we something like that. I think this can work, and then we do something. And then this is going to be the light we got in the tent, because this doesn't make sense that you put torches on the tent itself. So this is much better. I like that. Okay, let's clean up. No, let's clean up all of this mess. You need to go in there. And I need to go out and do the rest of these maps. But first we need to sleep, because baddies are out. And it's not bad. I must admit, I like this tent. I really think it's looking lovely. I like it, really like a war chief's area. I think that's kind of what it looked like. Got the big war map about the area, and look. Imagine this filled up trees. Oh, that's gonna be awesome. It's gonna take some time, but that's gonna be awesome. Gonna be really, really awesome. And I don't think it's completely uncompletable, if you can say it like that. It's over the top. It's a lot of work, but if we take, for example, this. Okay, let's do something there. If we take this chunk for itself, then take this chunk for itself. This is one thing, this is one thing. This area is one thing. This area is one thing. This area is one thing. This is going to be a big one. Area down to around about there is one thing. And you can see this area over here is one thing. Cut it up there, one thing. One. I think if we just take it like small chunks like that, I think it's not that bad. It's of course a lot of work. I know that. But I don't think it's that bad, to be honest with you. So, unfortunately, ladies and gentlemen, I kind of spend all the time messing around in this area. Even though I like it, we didn't get much done beside it. But I think it's a nice tent. I think it's definitely a big improvement to this area. I think that makes this area come together a lot more than before. However, we of course need more tents, and we will work on that later because we don't have time. But I want some tents over there, maybe one up there, and a little one down there. We need some more life today, and we also need some campfires, some pins for some horses, and all of that lovely good stuff. We need some pathways. We need to do all of the landscaping around here with some all the detailing on it. So there's a lot to be done, but I think this is a good start. This is definitely a good start. So ladies and gentlemen, have you liked this episode? Make sure to hit that like button. Have you really liked it? Make sure to subscribe. And as always, I hope you had some very Merry Christmas. And I do hope that you are... what is it called? New Year's Eve! That's the thing! Yay, New Year's Eve! Where we are going to blow up stuff and drink champagne and... no. I do hope that you get through that safe. And that you don't get in too much of a... hassle with the fireworks. Remember your protection for the eyes, because going blind is not something that's funny. And of course, I hope you have some fun time there with your friends and your family. And also, I'll see you again, ladies and gentlemen. May you have some very fine days ahead of you. Bye bye.